four white men lie.
You should be too, but no,
you know what that
you're
is?
Sin, and you're
Jesus black.
You know what
black
that
black
represents?
Let me ask you.
Right, get it again. Say it again on camera. Bro.
You know
say it
what?
One more time.
No, Jesus wasn't black, and you are not a Jew.
You see that?
And in all
that's
of your nationality
of you know
that you apply to,
you, know that
you show no love
on,
to white people who is Edom. And the Bible tells you not to hate thy brother Edom. So with all of the black nationalism, that's great. You have some spirit of to want to express yourself. But why not address the real issues in the black community? Why not address issues such as abortion? Because I don't see y'all in front of abortion clinics. I don't see y'all going against hip hop, going against that destructive music. I don't see y'all taming.
You
the
do
time.
That. Why you down here trying to ask them questions?
I'm just saying, if you really want to make.
Understand what that means?
No, I'm here.
Okay.
So you want
right,
to tell me?
Ahead.
Explain it.
We're going to explain. Go ahead. It's talking about the southern and northern kingdom of the nation of Israel.
That's right.
The blacks, the Native Americans, and Hispanics. That's what it's talking about.
I will also gather all nations.
He says he's going to gather all the nations,
bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat.
He's going to gather all nations and bring them down to the valley of Jehoshaphat. Read.
And will plead with them there for my people. And for my heritage, Israel.
So the Most High God said he's going to plead with the other nations for his heritage, Israel. Who is Israel? You, the Black Native Americans and Hispanics.
That's right.
The Most High God said he was going to come back and make war with the other nations for you.
What foundation do you have that on the blacks?
I'm going to show you. Read.
Whom they have scattered among the nations.
So here goes part of it. He scattered us among the nations during slavery. Read.
And parted my land.
And parted our homeland between
what about
the Palestinians. I'm going to show you. Between the Palestinians and what you call today Israelis or Jewish people.
I'm going to show you.
Read.
And they have cast lots for my people.
And they have cast lots, meaning what? Like we just said, nigga sold to Master Johnson. Nigga sold to Master William. Casting lots for his people on auction block.
That's right. And have given a boy for an harlot.
And given a boy for a harlot to breed more slaves. Read. We're going to explain. Read.
And sold a girl for wine.
I'm going to get this question first and then yours. Read.
And sold a girl for wine.
Read.
That they might drink.
Right. That's what they deal with our women. Sold them for wine that they might drink. And they rape and sex our women. Read.
Yay. What have you to do with me? Oh, Tyree and Tyrell.
I'm going
to
tell you.
Jay. Hold on.
God is not the author of confusion.
Exactly.
He didn't come here to cause division between us and any other race.
Brother,
God is a God
what
of
you
all
say?
People.
What do you
God,
have?
That's what God means.
Where's the Bible? Where's the Bible to prove what you say?
You can't take one scripture and base an entire world off of that.
Okay.
God, we all know God died for all people. He said, well,
you said
let us 3:16.
Give him a Bible.
He said, God so loved the world.
Give him a Bible.
Not just Israel.
He said, read. Read.
What have you to do with me? Like oh, Tyree and Zidon.
All right, here we go. It said, what have you to do with me? Tyree and Zidon, two African nations.
And all the coast of Palestine.
And the Palestinians that's in our land today. He says, what have you to do with me? Three.
Will you render me a recompense?
He said, will you render me a recompense?
And if you recompense me, quickly and speedily, will I return your recompense upon your own head?
Okay, so this is showing. I'm going to get you. See, look, y'all just talking. We're going to come out of the Bible. Yes, you can. Let me finish with him, and I got you. You ain't gonna forget your question. I'm gonna show you something. I know you don't hear y'all hate God law.
That's right.
We know that. We know you hate God law.
Let me ask you a question.
What's your question?
What makes you say we hate God?
I'm gonna show you.
What does this have to do with salvation?
It has. Give me what Christ said. Give me Matthew 19.
That's right.
Give me Matthew 19.
You
I'm going to show you how simple the Bible is when you study and you know what you're talking about.
That's right.
We're going to see what Christ
says. No! Matthew chapter 19, verse 16.
Hold on, brother. They trying to listen to the Bible right now. Bring it up.
And behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life?
So the question that we all have, what must we do to have eternal life? What does this have to do with salvation? You said, what does this have to do with salvation? Read.
And he said unto him,
hold on, brother. You want to hear what Christ said, or we're going to listen to you?
And he said unto him,
right. Christ is speaking. Read.
That's right.
What calls God me good? There's none good but one, that is God.
So Christ said there's none good but one, and that is God. Read.
But if thou will enter into life.
But if you want eternal life, if you want salvation,
yes, sir.
Keep the commandments.
No, do what?
Keep the commandments.
Christ said, keep the commandments.
What are
the commandments? Brother, there are over 600 commandments.
What
in the
are
Bible.
The commandments?
You go to Exodus 20.
What are the
I'll show you some commandments. No, matter of fact, give me Leviticus. Let me show you.
Bring it out.
Leviticus chapter 21, verse 5.
Read.
They shall not make garments upon their head.
Say what?
They shall not make baldness upon their head. Neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard.
So two commandments that you're breaking right now. You shall not make your head bald, and you shall not shave off the corner of your beard.
That's right. The fact of the matter is, I didn't have a choice but to go bald.
Brother, you can grow hair on the side.
And what does it say about going bald? What does it say?
Brother, it says if you forehead bald, you clean. Right. So it says you can't shave
so
off
what about, the head. Right. What about the kids that with the when they were making fun of the bald prophet when God's judgment fell on?
Because he was naturally bald. He didn't shave off
his
head.
Isn't that what I just said? Yeah. Did Am I not naturally bald?
Brother, we see your hair on the side of your head. Give me Numbers 15:38. No.
What you hear?
What you hear? Let me ask you a question.
Hold on. So if God's judgment fell on
give me
first 28. As a man, I'm going
to
talk to you.
I'm going to talk to you.
Isaiah chapter 58.
I'm going to
show you how much he hates the Bible. Because I'm going to give him his answer out of the Bible.
Right aloud.
His question was, why are you speaking so loud? Because I'm a Christian and my pastor don't speak like that. Read it again.
Cry aloud.
The Bible says cry aloud. Don't spare their feelings.
Right.
Lift up that voice like a trumpet.
Lift up your voice like a trumpet. That's very loud. Read.
And show my people their transgression.
And show my people
in the house of Jacob their sins. No. But what sins are you pointing out?
In the house of Jacob their sins.
So, what are we doing? We lifting up our voice like a trumpet. But showing you your iniquity.
For what purpose?
To get you deliverance. To get you salvation.
For what?
Deliverance.
I'm not going to. What are you delivering people from?
Bring it up.
What are you delivering?
The Bible answers all things, but when you don't study, you don't know.
Right.
So, how do you know? Wait, how do I know you don't study? You have friends, you don't know friends.
Right.
You out here with a bald head.
Right.
You don't have no Bible.
Who's in the judge in the back? Talk to God. Who's in the judge? I didn't have a choice but to be bald.
Who's in the judge? Verse 68.
Read.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
So first and foremost, he says, blessed be the Lord God of the nation of Israel.
That's right.
For he has visited and redeemed his people.
Read.
And they raised up an horn of salvation for us. And the house of his servant David. As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophet.
So he said, based on the prophecies, there will come a savior for the nation of Israel. Read on.
Which have been since the world began.
Because in John 1, he tell you, he was the beginning. Read.
That we should be saved from our enemies.
He said, saved from what? Read it again.
That we should be saved from our enemies.
Well, Christ said, I am coming to save you from your enemy.
That's right.
That's what salvation is.
That's right.
Who's the enemy? Give me Psalms 83.
That's right.
Yo, I'm going to show you what the Bible says.
That's right.
Can't even explain to you.
You don't know the Bible. Because you don't know God.
The Bible said the enemy.
Matter of fact, give me John.
Give me first John. What is your enemy? He saved you from your sins.
He's going to save you from your enemy.
Your sins.
Your sins,
man. The Bible says you have to be in Christ's word.
No question. There's only one truth.
Luke chapter 1, verse 71.
This brother's not mad.
That we should be saved from our enemies. And from the hand of all that hate us.
No, we should be saved from our sins. Please read it again.
That we should be saved from our enemies.
That we shall be saved from our enemies.
And from the hand of all that hate us.
And from the hand of all that hate us.
That's right.
We're going to get the enemy.
We're gonna get to heaven. So you're trying to tell me that I hate you? I don't even know you to hate you.
You don't keep the commandments, you hate yourself.
I'm keeping the commandments of God. And that's why I'm out here trying to save
the commandments
from their sin.
What are the commandments?
How many? Which ones?
We asked what all the commandments.
And I gave you a commandment.
No, they wasn't. No, it ain't.
It came out of the Bible. It's not
you never did.
You can find
the scripture anywhere to debate anything. But the Bible says,
First John chapter 3.
But the Spirit maketh alive. So if you don't have the Spirit of God, you won't understand the scripture.
Debate this.
First John chapter 2. Verse 3, and hereby we do know him, that we keep his commandments.
You say you know God.
What commandments?
Read it again.
And hereby we do know that we know him.
So if you say you know God,
if we keep his commandments.
It's only if you keep the commandments. Read.
He that said, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments.
So he that said, I know him like y'all, and don't keep the commandments.
He's a liar.
He's a liar.
You don't even know me. How you know I don't keep the commandments?
And the truth is not in him.
That would be he don't know his own.
How do I know? I'm going to give you a new
Why
testament.
Why are you yelling?
I'm going to give you a new
Let's
testament
like,
law.
Let's talk
to show
like brother.
How ignorant you are when it comes
Why
to
you,
the Bible.
Why you?
Give me 1 Corinthians 11.
First Corinthians chapter 11,
hold on. You know the Bible, right?
Hey, look.
You know the Bible,
hey,
right?
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, go ahead.
Why are you so?
We just read that. You're never asking the same question.
No,
Isaiah 58 tells you
hey,
why.
Calm down.
Isaiah 58 tells you why. I'm not bringing down nothing for you, brother. You're not an adult. You're not a man. You don't keep God's commandments.
You're not a man.
When you keep
God's,
I'm a man according to the Bible.
I can't tell.
Give me 1 Kings.
You don't even. I can't tell.
Read this. Please ask yourself.
You
no,
see that?
I mean, I know you
want to
go in. Y'all got to have this young boys, man. Go ahead, read this.
Ecclesiastes 7.
Bring it out. I'm going to show you how much.
Bring it out. Ecclesiastes 7 and verse 7.
Read.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
You see that? That's the difference between a man and a boy.
Right.
They look out here, they see oppression, and guess what? They don't get mad. Why? Because they comfortable in America. They see the condition of our people and they don't do nothing about it.
Bro,
they not changing no lives with that false doctrine. Right? When you go into this Bible, it's clear instruction. Clear. Read it again.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
So to be mad, you have to be a wise man according to the Bible. But only a wise man will be mad. Read it again.
Ecclesiastes chapter 7 and verse 7. Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
No, it makes a fool mad.
A wise man mad.
No, it makes a dummy mad.
A wise man mad.
A wise man's gonna be mad at the conditions of his people.
That's right.
Because this ain't about no one person, it's about our nation.
That's right.
But y'all don't know nothing about that because you're not studying.
Right.
So why am I mad? Because my people. Look at my people. That's why I'm mad.
That's
read it again.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad. And a gift destroyeth the heart.
A gift destroyeth the heart, meaning what? We've been given houses, good jobs, cars, whatever the hell you have. The Bible says those things destroy you.
He's cursed?
But the Bible curses, bro. You don't study, so you don't know that.
Right.
Read it again.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad. And a gift destroyeth the heart. Better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof.
We got a couple scriptures for you, but it's not beneficial. We are here to teach
something
else. You're
not even saved.
Okay, I'm going to show you. Give me Isaiah 1 and 3 first. Okay, we're going
to
see.
Can I tell him to read the scripture?
Give me Isaiah 1 and 3.
The Lord took me out the streets. Now
Isaiah. This scripture is going to help you. This is going to help you at the same time.
About you.
Isaiah chapter 1.
Nothing changed about me. You don't know
no.
me, bro. Read.
But
you
don't know
I know a man by his looks. Read.
Right. The ox knoweth his owner.
The ox knoweth his owner.
And the ass, his master's grill. And the ass, his master's grill.
The Bible just said an ox know his owner and a dumbass know his master's grill.
But Israel do not know.
But Israel don't know. Why? Because we too busy following a white image of Christ. Because we too busy worshiping the white man. Right. That's why we don't know who we are. That's why we destroy
it. God said all souls are mine, but the
show us the scripture.
Read 1 Peter 2 and 22.
Show us the scripture.
1 Peter 2 and 22.
Show us the scripture that says he's for all people.
You didn't answer my question about cursing, bro.
1 Peter 2
and 22. Bro, we read the scripture. You too busy talking.
I'm 1 Peter 2 and 22. That's about cursing.
We don't care about you.
You're not going to. That's
your scripture. That's talking about curses on your brother.
That's a scripture.
That's talking about putting curses on your brother.
You don't know it because you ain't reading it.
You read Peter, bro. We got other stuff to bring.
1 Peter 2 and 22. He committed no sin, no deceit, and he asked God to stop his mouth. But Israel do not know.
So again, it says, The head of every man is Christ. The Bible just said every man praying or prophesying, you coming out of the Bible with scriptures, and you got your head covered, you do what?
Dishonors his head.
He dishonored his head. Now, watch this. Give me up, Daniel. This sister want to know the image of God in Christ, all right? This
I want to know how y'all know God is blessed.
We're going to show you. We're going to show you. Are you going to listen? Are you going to listen? We know you love white Jesus, but we're going to show you the real image.
You hear me? Daniel chapter 7.
Hey, bro, that's how I see you ever knew.
I be held to the throne were cast down. And the ancient of days.
Hold on. Sister, how can you listen if you're talking?
I don't care.
You can't listen.
How you going to ask a question, but you don't care?
I ask a question. I say, how do y'all know God is blessed?
Read it.
Daniel chapter 7, verse 9. I beheld to the thrones were cast down.
It said I beheld to the throne were cast down. Let's talk about the other kingdoms. Read.
And the ancient of days did sit.
And the ancient of days did sit. Before time, before day. Read.
Whose garment was white as snow.
Whose garment was white as snow. Read on.
And the hair of his head.
And the hair of his head.
Like the pure wool.
Like the what?
Like the pure wool.
Like the pure wool. Like the pure wool. Now give me Christ. 10.
Where is he black? Where is he
saying? Revelations.
Go ahead. No, go ahead.
Revelations chapter 1 and verse 14.
Read.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So the first thing he says is that his head and his hairs were white. And then the second thing that it said, that it was like wool. White wool. We're going to show you.
And it's white as snow. And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
And his eyes were a flame of fire because he drank wine. Read.
And his feet like unto fine grass.
And his feet were like fine grass, like your color. But read on.
As if they burned in a fire.
He said he was so dark, it looked like he burned in a fire.
That's right.
That's how we know.
That's us.
We ain't out here to play games with nobody. They can worship white Jesus all they want. We know what the Bible says.
That's right.
It's not about worshiping the white Jesus.
It is about.
God is whoever
give me
you,
John
whatever you make him
no,
is. That's
not what the,
you know that your,
that's not what the Bible says. You must go according to what it says.
Number one, last time I checked, it might say the description, but does that mean he got wool here?
Who?
Anything can be wool.
Brother, it goes back to our seat.
But I'm saying, but you don't understand.
Well, I don't understand.
That there's not just blacks in this world.
We understand that there's not just blacks in this world. What does that mean?
Why does it matter what color he is?
Hold on. What makes you
John chapter 7 and verse 38.
Read.
He that believeth on me.
Read it again.
He that believeth on me.
Read.
As the scripture said.
No, as I believe in what I want. to make up.
He that believeth on me, as the scripture hath said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water.
They're not even listening. What did he say?
The only thing the Caucasian man fucked
with. Hold on, sis. What did he say?
That. But other than that,
he that believeth on me.
So the Bible says he that believeth on me.
As the scripture has said.
The scripture said he was a black man from the tribe of Judah. That he had an earthly father. This was the Bible says. So it says he that believeth on this Christ, as the Bible has said,
out of his bellies shall flow rivers of living water.
Out of his belly shall flow what?
Shall flow rivers of living water.
What are those rivers? Water. It's the word of God. That's right. When you go to Ephesians 5, it tells you that.
I don't got nothing.
Okay, so why are y'all teaching us something different from what we learned in the
Because they don't teach the truth.
That's right. The church.
Give me Ezekiel 3:11. I'm going
to
show
you.
You ain't got to listen. Go to your.
I'm just asking a question.
I'm going to give you an answer.
Why we can't listen to what they
say? I'm black people, bro. They don't say.
I mean, they stiff neck and rebellion.
Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 11.
Listen, sister, this is what they're not telling you in the church.
These people on crack. It ain't going to deliver.
And go.
Hold on.
It's keeping the same way. This stuff don't change. Only Jesus Christ changed. It don't matter what color he is.
Okay,
the Bible said, any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things.
Listen,
passed away.
He said Christ is what changed.
And he'll still be on crack. You can teach this to a fornicator. He'll still let him fornicate.
The law of the Lord.
Listen, sis. Do he have a Bible in his hand? He's just talking out of his mouth.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if you have a Bible or not.
The law of the Lord is perfect. Converting the soul.
It says the law of the Lord is perfect. Converting the soul.
That's right.
The law of the Lord is perfect. Converting the soul. Read it again.
The law.
This is for you. Read it again.
The law of the Lord is perfect.
It says the law of the Lord is perfect.
That's right.
Converting the soul.
Changing, converting the soul. You can Christ himself said, you have to have hope. And I'm going to prove it. Give me Revelation. I'm
going
to show you don't know this Bible, man. You don't know the Bible, man.
2 Corinthians 5 and 17.
You don't know the Bible. Read it.
Revelation chapter 14.
Verse 12.
Here is the patience of the saints.
Okay, now here's Revelation. This is the last book of the Bible. Let's see what it says in the Bible. Read.
Here is the patience of the saints.
Here, hold on, sister. Hold on, bro. Hold on. Sister, you heard him. He said only Christ, right? But Christ himself, when he came, he said it's two things you need. And what were those two things, Mr. Pastor?
He's the Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost is what? The law.
The power of God.
You're a fool. You don't know the Bible. Read this.
That's right. Here is the patience of the saints.
Acts 1 and 8.
Here are they that keep the commandments of God.
And what?
And the faith of Jesus.
You see that? It says, here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Christ. You can't just say, I believe in Christ and don't keep the commandments.
That's right.
Because the Bible is redundant, fool.
That's right.
Yeah, you're a fool. When you don't believe in God, the Bible says you're a fool. When you hate instruction, the Bible says you're a fool. Give me Proverbs 1. Y'all simple.
You know what the Bible says?
But there is no
Proverbs chapter 1, verse 21.
Read. A man might be saved other than the name of Jesus.
See Christ.
What is his name?
Jesus Christ.
No, what is his name according to the Bible?
Matthew 1 and 21. You know what it says? A virgin shall bring forth a son.
You see this? We ask
questions
with the Bible.
Thou shalt call his name Jesus.
We don't just go off our
head. We're going to prove
it.
Revelation chapter 19 and verse 12.
What is his name? Read.
His eyes were as a flame of fire.
Talking about the same image we've been talking about. Read.
And on his head were many crowns.
Because he was the King of Kings. Read.
And he had a name written thereon.
And he had a name for the people who are unlearned. What was his name?
That no man knew it by himself.
Read.
And he was, and his clothes was the best.
Verse 13.
And he was clothed with a vest dipped in blood.
Read.
And his name is called the Word of God.
His name is what?
The Word of God.
What do you find in the Word of God? His laws, statutes, and commandments.
That's right.
That's what you find.
Can y'all read Matthew 1 and 21?
We'll read it. We'll read this first.
See? Proverbs chapter 1, verse 22.
Read.
How long?
Read up. Verse 20.
Verse 20. Wisdom crieth out. She uttered a voice in the street.
The Bible says wisdom crieth out loud in the corners of the streets. Read.
She cried in the chief place of concourse.
Wisdom cried in the chief place of concourse. Read.
In the openings of the gate. In the city, she utters her words.
Wisdom utters her voice in the city, while people are. Read on.
Say, how long will ye simple ones?
How long what?
How long will ye simple
ones? How long will you simple ones?
Will ye love simplicity?
How long will you follow after that fake image of Christ and that damn abomination of a cross?
Right.
And those false doctrines of men?
Right.
How long will you be simple?
Right. And to the scorners, the light, and their scorning.
Read.
And fools.
And who?
And fools.
And fools.
Hate knowledge.
Fools hate knowledge.
That's right.
Fools hate knowledge. Read.
Romans 1:21, please.
Read.
Turn ye at my reproof.
The Bible says, turn ye at my reproof.
What are we reading out of?
The book of Sirach, chapter 12, and verse 6.
We're reading out of the Bible. What does the Bible say? Does the Bible say God loves everybody?
But the most high hated sinners.
Let's read it again so everybody can understand. Thank you.
For the most high hated sinners.
Read it again.
For the most high hated sinners.
Read it again.
For the most high hated sinners.
This is what people that actually read the Bible, this is what they do. They hear God's word, then they apply God's word.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.
That is the seventh. Read that again. A day has to start somewhere. Which day is the first day of the week? The first day of the week is Sunday. That's what I'm telling you. The first, you can Google it. You can look on the calendar.
Your friendly neighborhood white man, Esau. Read that again.
Woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord.
From the Lord. So the white man, your friend, sought to hide his counsel from the Lord. And he did that in slavery. Go ahead.
And their works are in the dark.
They separate, did that in the, said the Lord. And touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. So the Bible requires us to stay separate and stay amongst ourselves. And that's how you become able to establish an economy. When you stay to yourself, look out for yourself and for people who look like yourself, your people, who are to be the Israelites. That's how Israel rolled.